Yo, party people. What's up? Today's Monday. And, yep, it's May. Can't believe it. Did some exercising this morning, and today I'm pretty much dedicating my day to working on my sides right here. I've been working on them for the past few days. Got an audition tomorrow. So, yep, pretty much just acting. That's it, working on my acting. Been doing some research and, you know, a lot of mental preparation. I'm on my way to Giovanna's place right now to go work with her on this scene. I didn't want to just work on this alone. The last time I had a theatrical audition, I just worked on it myself, and then I kind of like ran lines with Nicole, and it still went well. The audition was good for me, I felt, but I think there's so much to be gained when you like work with another actor on it, bouncing the behavior and also the subtext off of each other. So I called Giovanna, and she's gonna help me do that today, and hopefully find some stuff. Yep, I talked to my agent earlier. I had to ask a question because I've been growing my facial hair out here because I'm on a veil for this project. And they want me to grow my facial hair out until the shoot. And the shoot is next week. And it's like the whole week. My audition tomorrow, the character is like clean shaven most of the time, so I had to call my agent and ask for some advice, like, what do I do in this situation? And because I thought the move would be to shave and then just grow my hair back out for this other shoot. It wouldn't be this long, but it would be long. It wouldn't just be like, you know, clean shaven baby face. But so she said just leave the hair and bring a picture of me clean shaven. So I'll do that. And yep, that's it. Tomorrow's my audition, and got another event in the evening I'll be going to with Max. A couple other acting friends I think will be there. It's like this Q&A with casting people, producers, agents, managers, and it's like a charity event, so that's cool. So yeah, I am just going to be focusing on this week, and I've been pouring a lot of my energy into this, so yeah, that's it. Just left an audition, and I'm going to go back to my car now, and that's it. I'm going to wash it. Put some gas in it and Uber. And yeah, I guess that's it for today. I got an event later. So yeah, I don't know. Casting is always an interesting thing. It's like it's such an ominous process. Really is. You don't know what the fuck's gonna happen. Just have to let it out there. And I feel like, you know, that's all I could do. So. Say hi.
Hi.
Where's Max? Can't zoom, damn it.
Like, no, you're always like looking at me.
Why you want to do this? Because as much as I have rage, I want to see you guys when you come on set, when you come to audition.
So. So I'm back in the kitchen here. Today is Wednesday. I am working on some sides here, different sides. This is for another audition I have on Saturday for a friend's theater company, Violet, and her crew over there, Camille and Cooper. So they are producing this play called Stupid Fucking Bird, which is a good play. And I need to work on these sides here for my audition, just to sort of find some stuff and play with it. I don't honestly think I'm gonna put the pressure on myself this time around to be completely off book. I think I'll just sort of make choices and that the lines will find themselves within my body. Sometimes, like, if I do that, the lines actually stick better. But we'll see. I mean, I'm not putting too much pressure on myself. Not that I don't want to book the thing. I definitely would like to be in this play. Especially working with them. It'd be cool. But, yeah, I just feel like, you know, especially after my audition yesterday, I put so much fucking pressure on myself that beforehand, like, I was so nervous. And it's just unnecessary. It really is. It's like I had to, like, take a lot of time to kind of work myself down from, like, the excitement, but also, you know, the work, and then just being like, all right, well, like, this, at the end of the day, like, it's not gonna, like, make or break me. So accepting that, and I think is a big deal. And then it was cool because last night I got to see and say what's up to Natalie at the event that we went to, so that was cool. But yeah, all these auditions and whatever the past couple months have been great, and you know, this is the life that I have asked for, and you know, it's kind of here. It's working up to that point, and now I just need to level up and get some more work under my belt, and you know, just get that body work. That's the most important thing. Like that's what's gonna remain. And that's what gets you more work anyway. So for me, it's like you're just constantly building your portfolio. So I kind of think of it as like if you at some point died and like people put up like a, I don't know what they call it. Oh, fuck, what is it called? If, like, a museum curated a section for you and, like, what they would put in there, like, I always think about it kind of like that, you know, where it's, like, you see all these paintings and all these works of all these great artists, and you're like, wow, that really speaks to a certain time in their life and just them as a whole. I think that's always really cool to reflect on, and I get inspired by that kind of stuff. So, I try to keep that in the back of my head, like, what kind of art can I create now, and why, and now can I level every piece that I do up in every medium, you know? I don't have to, it's not that, like, every piece of work needs to be better than the last, especially because if you're working in different mediums, it's like, I'm not that great at drawing. How is my next drawing going to be better than this play that I just did? It's not going to be, but within that medium, my next drawing might be better than my last drawing. Like, if it's not, okay, like, what can I take from that? So I'm just trying to think of it as like just focus on the art, and that's what means the most to me. And I'm having some fun working on these lines right now. And yeah, I'm gonna Uber today, and I had some, you know, real conversations about my finances just before with like a couple credit card companies, and you know, I it's just crazy because you know, I have all these big things have happened, and even the same day, yesterday, like, right after my audition, or before my audition, you know, probably the biggest one I've been on, and, you know, I checked my bank account right beforehand, thinking I still had, like, $50, and I'm, like, looking at it, and it's, like, $14, and I'm, like, oh, great, just enough to wash my car, put some gas in it, and go drive some people to make another $20-$30, and I did that, and now I'm, yeah, same thing, back at fucking $10 to go put some gas in my tank and drive some more people. Like, so that's it for today. That's the reality of it out here. And yeah, met some more actors or whatever at this thing last night, saw some familiar faces, and yeah, it's cool. It's a cool time. Max and I really want to put on an event, so we're gonna talk more about that. And yeah, more to come later. I just stopped Ubering, and I got sent all the way down to, like, Redondo Beach area, Manhattan Beach, and I was supposed to meet up with my Len before this event tonight, but it was gonna take me forever with traffic to get to her place, so I just had to, meet her here at CAA, but she said the parking situation this time is going to be not validated, so it's $15 to park there. $15 that your boy does not have. So, parked over here in the neighborhood. I'm going to have to walk for like 15 minutes to get over there. It's all good. I could use the air and the walking. Walking's good. I like walking. That's CAA there, but Santa Monica Boulevard. Just taking a lap around the courtyard here. Got some time to kill, but I'm just gonna head up into the lobby, chill. Things must end.
Do you want to head out?
Yo, what's up? What up? Just got an email from my agent, and I've been released from Avail for the Christ's Child project. And now that I've been released, I'm happy to talk about it. It was a project for Brigham Young Media TV, something like that. So the university has their own network and they create content or whatever. So I was going to be playing Joseph of Nazareth, the father of Jesus. So the young version. So yeah, the audition process started with the self-tape, and then I went to the callback, did well there, got the avail. They told me not to shave in anticipation of booking the role. And then Melanie just emailed me now and said I've been released, so I'm actually gonna shave now. And I kind of wish I did for this other audition that I went on Tuesday, but it's all good. I still feel good about that one, and I still feel good about this other one too. So who knows. I'm gonna try to, I got a breakdown forwarded to me from my LEN about a smaller non-union project, but working with some cool people, so I submitted to that just now. And what else? Max, Giovanna, John, and I had our deliberation this morning about the Pink Wall project, so we picked the scripts that we're going to be using, and sent out some emails, you know, having to let some people down and then congratulating some other people. And now we put out a casting call, an open call, and a director's call. So I just got a push notification for an audition. Let's see what it is. Cool. So I just got an email from the I just sent this email like 5 minutes ago. She responded in 2 minutes, and she said they booked the talent already, but they're gonna keep me in mind for future projects. So that's cool. So just as I'm getting ready to shave, and I got that push note for another audition, it says in the breakdown, unshaven Puerto Rican drug dealer. So I'll be going in for that tomorrow. On top of that, fucking Wells Fargo and their damn monthly service fees sneaking up and shit. $15. What the fuck is that? 15. So here goes my $15. I just got here to the LACMA, and I'm going to see this screening of Raging Bull. It's a free screening here. There's going to be a Q&A with a couple guys there. And it's going to be Erwin Winkler, producer, and Ryan Coogler, the director and producer. So that's cool, but the screening starts at 7:30, and I've been to a few of these before, and you got to get there early, so I'm here. It's about 5:50, so I'll be chilling outside for a while, just getting my my sit on, just chilling.
Thank you. long story, but it started, actually, the first job I ever had in show business, which is really hardly a show business job, but it was on the boardwalk of Coney Island. They had a ride, which was a bubble car ride. And this was my introduction to show business, because when the cars would get stuck,
I'm in Burbank, about to go to an audition real quick, and yep, just two quick pages. I say that, it's funny, because these two pages, you know, a lot less pressure than the two pages that I did for that other audition, and it's like, such a different feeling. But about to walk up to this casting office right now. Never been to this one. This is Jackie Pittman casting. So yeah, first time here. That's good. And just like that, it's over. It's so fun. These fuck auditions just crack me up. You know, you put so much time in. I mean, this one I didn't go crazy with, just because I didn't actually have the time, but you know, you put so much fucking time into it, and then you go in and you're out. Literally, it's like that. That's it. You leave it out there. Just did a little car vocal warm up. You know, massaging the jaw,
doing my buzz, my laws, my cuz, guz, tuz, does, rolling my R's, tongue twisters, speaking with way too much going on in your face.
But I'm on my way to this audition, and yeah, that's it for today, audition, and then I'm gonna Uber, and probably do some more computer work at home, work on some projects, some writing, and some other stuff, and that's it for today.